So in traditional, I guess this is a JRPG thing. It's got to be a JRPG thing. Because you seem to do this in, like, every JRPG ever. But, well, Traverse Town. The pillar setup. It's just like, yep, we are revisiting each world in the state of which it was when we first appeared, when we were first there. As opposed to the crappy situation they're in now. Yeah, that's how I'm gonna put that. But they are, you know, powered up versions of all the enemies. They are the... I mean, they didn't give this world a level 10 rating for no reason. And I'm gonna be gaining levels like nuts because of the questions asked... of how I answered the questions at the beginning of the game. I answered them so that my journey would start at night, and so my I level up fast after level 50. And since I'm at like level 61 now, yeah, level 61. So I'm gonna be, you know, off the charts as far as levels. And I actually did that on purpose. That was to make it an easier time leveling for the secret bosses. I can beat this game no problem. Not to brag. I don't mean to brag. But it's gonna cut me off like I'm bragging because I don't know how else to say it. When I first beat the game, I was probably not even level 50. I also didn't know what the questions at the beginning of the game meant until after I had already answered them. And someone told me never to choose the shield, always get rid of the shield, and I'm like, why would you do that? Just like how in this playthrough I picked the shield. Can we come down here? Oh, this makes me leave. Right? Yeah. That's my exit point. Now, what is up with my mic? It's like starting to sputter in the, anyway. This is kind of interesting how, the Olympus Coliseum is. It's like the nighttime sort of time. That's how I'm gonna put that. Nighttime sort of time. But, we are in the, you know, we're outside the Coliseum. We're not in the Coliseum. I think that's cool. I think it's really cool, actually. I think this is a really cool part of the game, just because it's like, look at all these places we've been to. Especially since, like, in someone's, like, normal playthrough, they probably weren't like me going back to each world to pick up collectibles and stuff. They probably, you know, are like, oh, let's just get on with the story, man, right? Yeah, probably. Can actually explore, you know. We're not gonna worry about it. There is a chest in each world, though, that I don't even know what they like all contain. They're like different accessories that supposedly will help you out. I guess it's not the way I'm going. I guess I'm going back out this way. Awesome. Oh, one thing I want to do. Yeah, that's... Whoops. Didn't mean to exchange. I wanted to take out. Two of those. Mega ethers. Mega potions.
Here!
You know. Take out my potion and elixir. That's how we're gonna do that. I I won't right now, but when we get to Ansem, I will give Goofy and Donald items too. So here we've got Deep Jungle again. I don't know what to say. I mean, we don't have to go here. I'm just doing it, you know. I'm doing it mostly for the items. We could totally skip. Like, in a speed run, I would skip past this. But I want to get the items. White Fang. Do you know it doesn't have words to be said? Reza, is it? This one should be Agrabah, right? Yeah. Alright. So where's our item in here? This one I don't remember. Damn! I took him down in like one strike raid. Ooh, a blaze gem. Look at that. That was great. What we call kicking names and taking ass. Is it like way up high here? Yeah, there it is. Ray of light. Thought it was a trinity for a moment. I'm like, what the heck? What's going on? Alright, let's get out of here. Alright, here's Atlantica. The trick here is not getting caught in the cyclone. Fire. Fire. Yeah, that cyclone tends to be annoying. Alright. AP up. That's beneficial. I'm actually gonna use that now. Use this power up on Sora. Defense up on Sora. AP up on Sora. Okay. Oh, I have another one. Cool. Oh, I guess I didn't have to worry about it, because the exit's... Stop! Okay. Over here. Derp! Derpy herp. Alright, let's go. This one should be, Halloween Town. Ah, in Oogie's room. See, I like the room choice here. They're like, oh, we're gonna put you in Oogie's Manor. Great. I like it because it's a room you never really got to explore. But, you know, it's where you had your boss fight. So, you know, it's not a new room. But it's, like, new because, like, you didn't get to see much of it. And you actually can't go back to it. We went back to where Oogie's Manor was. And it was the manor ruins. Oogie's Manor isn't there anymore, so you can't really go and see this. So it's nice that they put this here. I swear that said strike, but okay, whatever. Holy circlet. That was cool. I like dodge rolling into these. It's kind of funny. See, that's how you know it's not Neverland. I can't fly. Kind of hoping I would be able to. I don't know why I couldn't. I didn't. Oh, yeah, I just do that. Thanks. I forgot I did that. Alright, Raven's Claw. Ta-da! And this one's got a green flame. The final countdown. Pooh Bear. That's right, they gave you another save point here. This one, we can head to the gummy ship, but we don't need to. Alright, so I recommend making sure your items are aligned how you wish for them to be. I want this magic armlet. Alright, we're good. To leave there, you just need to leave in any direction, and then we can move on. Fire! Now this is interesting. And it leaves room for speculation, actually. Supposedly, and this is what I believe. I don't know if this is like what other people believe too, but this is the how, you know, we're revisiting worlds. This is Halabastion, which, you know, how much of Halabastion were we supposed to see, and what didn't we see of Halabastion? That's my question. Especially when we look into, like, Kingdom Hearts 2, which I'm not going to spoil. But things get interesting. Especially this room. This room piques my interest a lot. Pick up a Mega Elixir there. Ones born of the heart and darkness, devoid of hearts, ravage all worlds and bring desolation. Seize the hearts and consummate the great heart. All hearts to be one. One heart to encompass all. Realize the destiny. The realm of Kingdom Hearts. The great darkness sealed within the great heart. Progeny of darkness. Come back to the eternal darkness. For the heart of light shall unseal the path. Seven hearts, one keyhole, one key to the door. The door of darkness, tied by two keys. The door of darkness to seal the light. None shall pass but shadows, returning to the darkness. Ones born of the heart and darkness. Hunger for every heart until the dark door opens. Not dealing with you, sir. Thank you very much. So, yeah, it's an interesting thing when you look at the entire spectrum of the Kingdom Hearts chronology, I guess you could say. There's a giant Heartless emblem here that stops us from going on. Yeah. Makes you think. That's not the... Oh, yeah, we have to jump back in here. I'm like, where am I going?